And welcome to Divisibility Rules 2. In this video, you'll learn the divisibility rules for 3, 6, 9, and 12. These rules let you know at first glance if a number can be divided by another number. And it makes long division and doing math in your head a lot easier. You can learn more about divisibility rules by watching the Divisibility Rules 1 video. So let's get started. We're going to start with the divisibility rule for the digit 3. And to find this rule, we just have to add up the numbers in the dividend. And remember, the dividend is the number that you're dividing into, and see if that number is divisible by 3. This is pretty confusing, so let's do an example. ~141 divided by 3. We add up the numbers 1, 4, and 1, which is 6. And since we know that 6 is divisible by 3, that means 141 must be divisible by 3. The rule for the digit 6 is a little bit more complicated. Basically, you combine the rules for 3 and 2. This means that the last number of the digit has to be even, and the sum of the digits in the dividend have to be divisible by 3. Let's do some examples.
4 divided by 2 equals 2. 4 is divisible by 2, therefore 114 is divisible by 2. 1 plus 1 plus 4 equals 6. 6 divided by 3 equals 2. 6 is divisible by 3, therefore 114 is divisible by 3. Since 114 is divisible by 3 and 2, we know that it is also divisible by 6.
Now, let's look at another example. 344. Again, the last digit is even, so it passes that rule. But when we add them up, 4, 4, and 3, it's 11, which is not divisible by 3. Even though it passes one rule, if it doesn't pass both rules, this number is no good. So 344 is not divisible by 6. The rule for the digit 9 is the same as the rule for 3, except the sum of the digits must be divisible by 9, not 3. Let's look at some examples. We have 657. 6 plus 5 plus 7 is 18, which is the same as 2 times 9. So this one works. Let's look at another one. 1989. That's a big number, and it adds up to 27, which is the same as 3 times 9. So both of these numbers we know are divisible by 9. The divisibility rule for the digit 12 is a lot like the rule for 6, except it relies on the rules for 3 and 4. This means that the digits in the dividend have to add up to a multiple of 3, and the last two digits have to be a multiple of 4. This is pretty confusing, so let's do some examples. First, we have 216. 2 plus 1 plus 6 is 9, which is divisible by 3. And the last two digits are 16, and 16 is a multiple of 4. So we know that 216 is divisible by 12. Let's do one more. We have 324. 3 plus 2 plus 4 adds up to 9. So again, it's divisible by 3. And the last two digits are 24, which is a multiple of 4. And because of this, we know that 324 is divisible by 12. Thank you so much for listening. You can practice divisibility rules with our games, which can help you do big math easier and faster. So until next time, always be clever. Hey, hey.